Hello, it's Bernie Golbach on the 30th of October, 2011, outdoors in Ireland, where it's 10 degrees centigrade, it's raining, and I'm Topquote on Twitter, bringing you the Sunday news in American's accent in the back garden, Cashel County, Tipperary, Ireland, where I'm thinking about creative things like Aardman and Pixar. The article is called A Bid for Creature's Comforts, and Roland White talks to the shy animator Nick Park. In a story which I really like, they're auctioning away different pieces of artwork on eBay, hoping to raise about 15,000 sterling for a children's hospital. I like the stuff I show up in my class in a digital design as well as in a media writing class. That's from Up, Pete Doctors. And here's another interesting thing that Park's noting. He's saying when he's looking at the film industry, he really thinks that there's more people employed in animation today than in any other part of the film business. Good words. More articles about this on the sundaytimes.co.uk and culture. I read the Irish broadsheets on a Sunday for news that fits my interest. Front page of Sunday Business Post talks about the presidential election, and most of these newspapers are all about that. Occupy Wall Street, Battle of the Bonds, and outside my house, the sound that the recession's not really hit in yet because the boy racers rule the roads. Government set to slash growth forecast for 2012, so says Pat Leahy and Cliff Taylor in the front of the Sunday Business Post. Big stamp on the December budget, which will be unveiled December 16th, is austerity, no matter how you put it. Lots of coverage about Michael D. Higgins. People say it's a big vote for the leprechaun in Irish society. Michael D. well deserved that role of President of Ireland. And if you follow me on youtube.com/talkgold, you'll know that I said he'd probably win that. Well, I just repeated what the bookies said. The bookies didn't have anything about this, which is flood claims reaching up to 100 million euro. And McKennedy points out there's been a massive deluge of water hitting the around the Dublin area, and it's going to cost premiums, and it's going to cost people who have homes and businesses to insure. Costs for China. Direct approach paying off for PCH in China. Smiling face of Liam Casey. Chief executive of PCH from Cork. He's knows how to do the business, and he's doing PCH China Direct, leveraging an external the extensive experience in China to create a new business that's going to allow big name global brands to sell directly to the Chinese domestic market. Big deal. Big deal. I got the In Gear section here because I'll show it to you. The In Gear section talks about something that happened last week, Nokia World 2011. Two articles here in the Your Tech section of the Sunday Business Post. Hey, I'll cut to the quick, though. Adrian Weckler from the Sunday Business Post really should have just gone straight to the top of the Lumia brand, Lumia 800. So like the Gear section, the In Gear section of the Sunday Times says, Windows operating system, they like it. Well, actually, they say it only has a small slice of the market. It's quick, clever, and adaptable. And you know, I've played around with that Lumia 800 hands-on and the 710, its small baby brother, and it works. David Phelan did too, and I think it's going to result in Nokia clawing back some of the market share. Probably not getting back to where it used to be at the top of the market, but definitely going to be more than 30% of the smartphone market within a year and a half. Perhaps in this car too, the accessory, the Windows Phone dock, will link into this Mini Cooper or this Mini Roadster. It's pretty interesting stuff that you're putting in the dashboard of that car. You know, you've got this infotainment system, internet link, web radio, Google services, RSS newsfeed, in-car access to Facebook and Twitter, all without a phone. Telemetrics going mad, don't you think? So, what else? This deserves to be mentioned. Bloomberg is the source of the story from Diana Ben-Aaron. She says, look, Diana says, the phone maker, Nokia, hopes Angry Birds is going to lift Symbian. Hey, listen, that the map experience will, and the longer duty days you're going to get out of these phones will. I mean, Nokia knows how to build a phone that lasts the whole day. Try it with any kind of an iPhone. Now, what you're going to give up, though, is faster browsing, because the browser won't render as fast because the processor on board these Nokia phones isn't as good, isn't as powerful, but it fits the 14-hour duty day better, at least in my experience. And here's the point I'm making about the smartphone market. Gartner thinks that the Windows Phone may become the second most prevalent smartphone operating system in 2015, market share of 21%. I actually think it'll go up there higher than that. Okay, lots of other stuff in Sunday Business Post. including a piece from Catherine Mahoney in Media World. She's basically saying news outlets can learn from the iPad too, and the way it's surging, how people tend to read email and read news on their iPad. Statistically, news junkies, that's what those iPadders are. Catherine, big clue. I think the real news is in HTML5. Because, you know, these newer, the iPad 2 and iPad 3 can render really well. HTML5 is what renders. And here's another clue. Piece of pop culture advertisement. If you look at the U2 Octoon Baby re-release, it's a 20th anniversary edition. Those are panes, baby. And if you'd see these panes running on a Windows phone, you'd see that both the Windows phone experience with smart widgets, you don't need an app for that, just smart widgets coming off the back of an API call, anybody can make for much less than an app. Smart widgets and HTML5, I think, deserve more treatment than they're getting. Hey, Deloitte Technology Fast 50 Awards for 2011. Rising stars light up the economic landscape. Linda Daly has the article. Focuses on 16 South. I like what they're doing with big and small. I actually have a four-year-old that really likes that. And Customer Minds, a smart, integrated management company. You can see more about the Technology Fast 50 Awards by going to fast50.ie. I've dealt with some of them and checkmarked them. Blueface, DigiWeb, Nubase Software, Terminal 4. I really like the stuff. And here's the other thing I like. You know, if you're looking at fast growth, like lighting up the economic landscape, you might look at food, because the foodie boys are really going nuts. Keith Bahan, if you're listening, I'm watching what you're doing. Clever stuff. And I'm bookmarking this audibly for myself, because I'm going to take this little presentation over to audible.fm/topcon, listen to myself. Thinking about salmon and cucumber wraps, because I got the basics of this in my fridge already. Wasabi. Salmon. Wraps. Lunch next week. Follow my flow on flickr.com/topgold. See if I actually take that to the classroom. Voters from the Sunday Times did the number, electing your man, Michael DeHiggins. And this is the bigger story, perhaps. Gay Mitchell from the ruling party sucks. No comment. Didn't show up for the congratulations, Michael, event. And more importantly, it draws questions, because Fine Gael, the ruling party in Ireland, had to take out a mortgage on their Mount Street property to fund a losing campaign. They're not going to get that money back, because they didn't get a quota. Gabe Mitchell didn't get a quota. You Owe Me One, later invention by Sinn Féin. Interesting stuff here for a PR class. The word is equivocation. And the article points out how Sean Gallagher stumbled by equivocating. Read the rest of the story and be ready for a final exam question. The News Review gives away the whole page, front and the whole inside section of the News Review, to an extract from Walter Isaacson. And it's actually on my Kindle. I'll let it light up here. Because the point is, Steve had the say for what the photo would be on the cover of the book. That's the approved photo. Steve Jobs. I like reading this in the Kindle because I can see everybody else's annotations. A lot of interesting annotations from people I follow on these different social networks. Cool way to read. Face-to-face is still a better way of dealing with that. I trade real books. Gabrielle Monahan has a story about networking, how to make it work. The thing I'm emphasizing here is communicate what you do in 7 to 10 words. Think Twitter. Can you tweet an autobiography that's accurate? And then if you're involved in some space like I am, which is academic, I should be perhaps published and peer-reviewed more. I'm not doing that well. Dr. John Bartlett explains maybe I'm having a problem with my lack of peer review, especially in my new job at Limerick Institute of Technology. And here's another problem. Shadow falling over the solar industry. Oliver Shaw points out that there's accusations out there that the Chinese are dumping all kinds of solar gear on the international market. Are they really? Tom Rafferty, you would know. Okay, if I was going to recommend something for you to buy for the Christmas season, it might be this book, Ghosts of the Faithful Departed by David Creedon. If you're a longtime listener and you're in Thailand, Cambodia, Vietnam, far away from here, interesting book here because it may be actually a reflection of your own past. Creedon walked into a lot of unoccupied homes, especially out west, took pictures of them. What you may not know by looking at the image, he was inside there with medium format cameras, tripods, open aperture, no flash. Caught some interesting looks inside of homes. If you walked around my home, you'd find out that It's fall. My dahlias are still up. The pyracantha's coming. I'm listening to the Sod Show for techniques about how I might give color to my back garden. Stuff I had to clip back like my ferns. And out front and down the street, the undeniable presence of fall. There are more photos up on flickr.com/photos/irisheyes if you're interested in watching the seasons change. Otherwise, listen to me on Twitter as Topgold. I appreciate you listening in this week, the end of October. Happy Halloween, and bye for now.